You want to add 4.7 years to your life so that you can enjoy more time with your loved ones or do things that give you fulfillment in life. You need to watch this video. I'll be showing you the correct dosage and a brief overview of the different forms of the supplement. In the Huberman Lab podcast titled Micronutrients for Health and Longevity, Andrew Huberman, PhD, interviewed scientist Dr. Rhonda Patrick about the science behind using micronutrients, supplements, heat, and cold for optimal brain and body health. So what is the top nutrient for longevity? According to Dr. Rhonda Patrick, regular intake of omega-3 fatty acids can help support longevity when combined with a healthy regularly intake, including oily fish in the diet, which are high in omega-3 fatty acids, increases life expectancy by almost 4.7 years based on scientific research. The scientific research are linked in the description below. What is science behind dietary omega-3 fatty acids' positive effect in the body? This is how omega-3 fatty acids work in the body. Omega-3s like EPA and DHA are powerful anti-inflammatory nutrients. Inflammation is implicated in numerous chronic diseases and conditions. Omega-3 fatty acid help resolve inflammation by stimulating the production of pro-resolving lipid mediators like resolvins and protectins. These compounds actively turn off inflammatory processes that are no longer needed. Omega-3s also modify the production of inflammatory eicosanoids like leukotrienes and prostaglandins. They compete with arachidonic acid for incorporation into cell membranes and form less potent signaling molecules. At a cellular level, EPA-DHA influence the fluidity, structure, and function of cell membranes. This affects the behavior of membrane-bound proteins like receptors and ion channels. The altered signaling properties modulate neurotransmitter release, immune cell function, and more. Several human trials show clinical benefits of omega-3 supplementation for mood disorders, cognition, joint pain, and cardiovascular disease risk factors. The anti-inflammatory and cell-regulating capacities of EPA and DHA likely contribute to these far-reaching effects. How can you check your omega-3 levels? The omega-3 index is a measure of the amount of eicosapentaenoic acid, EPA, and docosahexaenoic acid, DHA, in the blood, specifically in the red blood cell membranes. So the index indicate. The omega-3 index is considered a risk factor for heart disease, similar to cholesterol. It is hypothesized that raising the omega-3 index levels will reduce the risk for cardiac events. The risk zones for the omega-3 index are as follows. High risk, less than 4 intermediate risk, 4-8% low risk, more than 8%. However, most people hover around 6% or below. And unfortunately, in the United States, most people are at 4% or below, the highest risk zone. This is the most common omega-3 fatty acid in your diet. It's mostly found in plant foods and is an essential precursor of EPA or DHA. However, this conversion process is inefficient in humans. Eicosapentaenoic acid, EPA. Your body uses EPA to produce signaling molecules called eicosanoids, which play numerous physiological roles and reduce inflammation. Docosahexaenoic acid, DHA. DHA is crucial for the health of the brain and retina. It is abundantly found in the brain and retina and is critical for their normal function. It's important to note that while ALA is found in plant oils such as flaxseed, soybean, and canola oils, EPA and DHA are found in fish and other seafood. What are the different forms and characteristics of omega-3 fatty acids? 1. Triglycerides. This is the natural form in which omega-3s are found in fish. When consumed, triglycerides are broken down into monoglycerides during digestion to be fully absorbed. 2. Ethyl esters. In this form, omega-3s contain ethanol. After consumption, the ethyl ester needs to be broken down into the EPA-DHA component and the ethanol component. The EPA and DHA are then converted to a triglyceride form by the body. Phospholipids. This form of omega-3 is found in krill oil and is easily absorbed by the body. How much omega-3 should you take per day? As for the dosage, it varies depending on the individual's health status and dietary habits. However, most health organizations recommend a minimum of 250 to 500 milligrams of combined EPA and DHA each day for healthy adults. This can be obtained from about 8 ounces of fatty fish per week. For certain health conditions, higher amounts are often recommended. For example, for people with high triglycerides, the American Heart Association recommends a dose of 4,000 milligrams per day. There is another essential nutrient discussed in the conversation between Andrew Huberman and Dr. Rhonda Patrick. It is called astaxanthin.
Astaxanthin. So astaxanthin,
antioxidant that may protect cells from damage. It's also known as super vitamin E because it's more powerful than other carotenoids in vitamin C and E. Astaxanthin is found in the flesh of pink-hued seafood such as salmon and crustaceans. This nutrient may support skin, muscle, and eye health, healthy aging, and enhance your immune system. Astaxanthin is a natural red-pigmented ketocarotenoid found in some types of microalgae and yeast. It's known for its powerful antioxidant properties and plays a role in protecting your cells from free radicals and oxidative stress. Astaxanthin can be classified into two forms according to the fatty acid it binds. 1. Astaxanthin monoester. This form of astaxanthin is esterified with 1 fatty acid. Astaxanthin diester. This form of astaxanthin is esterified with 2 fatty acids. How much astaxanthin per day? Astaxanthin is safe to take daily. As for the dosage, there is no set dosage for astaxanthin, although some studies have recommended doses of 4 milligrams per day. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA, has approved doses up to 12 milligrams per day. Astaxanthin has most often been used by adults in oral doses of 4 to 18 milligrams daily for up to 12 weeks. Doses of up to 20 to 50 milligrams astaxanthin have been tolerated, although the exact toxicity and upper limit is not known. Astaxanthin products are commercially available in various forms such as tablet, capsule, syrup, oil, soft gel, cream, biomass, and granulated powder. It's important to remember that while supplements can help you reach these levels of omega-3 blood level index, it's generally better to get your nutrients from food if you can. But beware of polluted salmon, particularly farmed salmon, can be harmful to health due to the accumulation of toxic chemicals in their fatty tissue. These chemicals include persistent organic pollutants, PIOP, such as polybrominated diphenyl ethers, PBDE, flame retardants, polychlorinated biphenyl, PCB, dioxin, a byproduct of pesticide manufacturing, and ethoxyquin, a pesticide preservative in fish feed. It's important to consider the source of your salmon, including omega-3 fish oil supplements, and opt for wild-caught when possible to avoid these potential health risks. Always consult with a healthcare provider before starting any new supplement regimen, especially if you are pregnant. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button below and subscribe for more content like this. Be a helper. There you have it. Take care of yourself and your health. Thanks for watching to the end, and I'll see you in the next video.